Brook trout are now one of the most common fish in Banff National Park. They're from Eastern Canada, and they're extremely competitive and capable of outcompeting West Slope cutthroat trout and bull trout. They're a completely beautiful fish, but at the time that they introduced them, nobody had any idea that they would become so competitive and start to imperil the fish that belong here. In 2018, we did our first pilot rotenone application. We were able to apply rotenone to Hidden Lake and remove all of the fish in a half a day, something that we couldn't do in 5 years of gill netting and electrofishing. We decided to use remote stream incubation as the method to reintroduce fish into the Hidden Lake Basin. We've been working with the Allison Brood Hatchery in southern Alberta, and they take care of the eggs for the first 20 days, and then they give them back to us when they are a little bit bigger and a little bit more mature, and then we put them back into the lake or stream. We create these artificial egg nests. They're inside of buckets, and it allows the eggs to finish their next 10 to 15 days in the water that they're going to live in for the rest of their life. Although it's challenging to do, it also has really tremendous benefits. So the first reason we chose it is that it causes the least harm to the very few populations of West Slope cutthroat trout we have left, because we're not taking adults, we're just taking some of their eggs and milt. And then we bring them back when they're partially mature to the streams that they're going to finish their maturity in. And this does a few things. It helps avoid some of the behavior effects that you get when you raise fish in the hatchery. They bond onto their home lake or stream. They have better survival. We're trying to select the most diverse genetics, because this diversity in the genetic base is going to give these fish the best chance to survive, especially in the face of some challenges that are coming their way, like climate change.